Ladies and gentlemen, today is my honor to introduce the most important image generator in the modern history, the AI you-know-who, Stable Diffusion. Stable Diffusion is a very important artificial intelligence tool and it's quite popular all over the world. Some people claim that Stable Diffusion is the best AI tools. And I think one feature that other software or other artificial intelligence cannot compete is Stable Diffusion is open source, which means it's totally free from beginning to the end. It's totally free. So everything you can make with Stable Diffusion, like the images, like the videos, like the audio, like 3D, like the languages, totally free. That is so unbelievable. Every artificial intelligence that we already introduced, like the Midjourney, like whatever you in your mind, like a Pika, like everything else, they charging your money, but Stable Diffusion charging your computer. Okay, so if you are check my video through a MacBook, then Stable Diffusion may not be easier for you to use, and if you are using a Windows computer, that may be easier. Some settings of the Stable Diffusion requires Windows. It's lot of easier, but if you are a MacBook user, you also can find some tricks to use it. Okay, so now this is the Stable Diffusion's official website introducing the latest version, Stable Diffusion 3. Medium. Stable Diffusion 3 Medium is the latest and the most advanced text-to-image AI model in our Stable Diffusion 3 series, compromising 2 billion parameters. This is quite amazing. And also there are more artificial intelligence tools that's produced by Stability.ai, but Stable Diffusion is our main character. But how to use it is quite hard for ordinary people like me. First thing first, you need to get a Git. So here is the official website of the Git. I will put it in our bio so you can check it out later. When you download it and install it, you also need Python. Python is another very important environment for Stable Diffusion, and you can download the latest version and use it by free. And after that, you need to go to another website, the third website. This is a GitHub of Stable Diffusion, and you can get the code from there. So after 3 jobs are done, and you are halfway down, there are many great tutorials inside of the YouTube. You can check later. And when you download the Git and download the Python, then download the code of Stable Diffusion and install all of them, and you are good to go. You will see this page. But I use a special trick to install this Stable Diffusion with the help of the very brilliant Chinese engineer. And if you would like to see, I will also leave the link in the bio. And after that, you might see this. Some texts are Chinese, but yours are English. It's totally fine. First thing first, we can go to the Stable Diffusion folder, then click Models, then find Stable Diffusion. So here, this folder is for you to save all your models. What is models? If you're on a different style of the images, you might need to download the different AI models. Okay, but later I will teach you how to train your own AI models. So if you're working for a company or you're working for, let's say, your wife, and you can train your own AI model so every image will exactly look like your wife or your company's product. And I will recommend 3 websites to download the AI models. First is the prompt hero. So click Stable Diffusion tab, you will find there are a lot of examples of the models. And if anyone interested in you, you can click. And then you will find you can download the models from here, download AI model from here. Yeah. And this model called Stable Diffusion Base. Okay, this one called CVTi. So in the website, you can click the models, and also same way, same trick, you can find everything that interests you, and you click here, and you find the download button. Oh, this is big. So the AI models are huge, and you can sleep on it and let your computer run all night, and in the morning you will find, hey, I got 1.5 models. Okay, when you download the AI models, you are able to select from here. So I'm using this AI model, and then we will leave everything empty, and here we are able to type the prompt. If you see anything that interests you in other websites, you can also copy and make tweaks on them. For example, like this one, we can check the prompt from here, click this button to copy all the prompt, and back to Stable Diffusion and paste it. And also, here's negative prompt. What does this mean? This means everything you don't want. Therefore, we can copy the negative prompt. And here is the width and the height. We can change it to some ratio that you like it to be. Okay, 124. And basically, that's it. Let's generate our first image by click the generate button. Okay, here we go. We have our first image here. The size is good, the image is good, and the artificial intelligence avoiding showing the hand. And face is nice. We can save the images and we can generate more. Okay, this is how you generate your first image by Stable Diffusion. And in the next episode, I will introduce how to generate image to image and also play around with the models and also other great features. Congratulations, you finished this episode. And don't forget to subscribe us and please click the like button. Also, leave all your questions inside of our comment zone. I will see you on the next episode. Bye-bye.